Deborra-lee Furness is an acclaimed actress and director, but she's also well known as the founder of not-for-profit foundation Adopt Change, which she founded back in 2008. I caught up with Deborra-lee in New York and the CEO of Adopt Change, Renee Carter, about a new campaign that launches today.
There are children in Australia who can't live with their parents and worry about where they're going to sleep tonight. Who will take care of them? While many of these 46,000 children now live in foster care or kinship care, 4,000 homes for kids are urgently needed. Can you provide a home for one child? Help us find a home for every child.
Well, it is so good to catch up with you two. It is, of course, the start of the Yesvember campaign for Adopt Change today. Tell me what the priorities are for this year.
Well, we urgently need 4,000 homes across Australia for long or short-term care. That is our big push this year, and I think we can achieve it. We can find 4,000 homes. Our two big pushes this year are carers to look after these kids, or please donate so we can continue our work, which is, you know, advocating for these children, working with carers and agencies to pursue homes. We're supporting foster and adoptive families in caring for children. So there are two big pushes. But come on, there's got to be 4,000 homes out there that can look after these children. And a lot of these kids are under the age of five.
Under the age of five is terrifying. Renee, why is this number so desperate right now? What's occurred?
Look, we've known for years the numbers have been around 46,000 in care, but really I think in the last 2 years with the COVID environment that we've seen more pressures on families, harder to get to children at risk with caseworkers during lockdowns. And so I think we're seeing some of that fallout now, and we're seeing an increase in the number of children that aren't in homes.
Deb, what does it take to open your home? What sort of person are you looking for? Who can do this?
Obviously, you've got to have empathy for wanting to care for a child. I mean, we facilitate training, so we train people up on how to care for a child. Look, we're all humans. We see a vulnerable child. Who wouldn't want to put their hand up to support this child? So just opening your heart and sharing your home and giving guidance, being a mentor, you know, this is a child in need. That's pretty much all it takes, is a big open heart.
And what sort of difference can it make to that child's life if they do get to go into a safe home environment?
Children growing up in residential care or any group in a group home don't get the same as a loving family. We all need to feel that we're precious. We all need to feel special and have guidance of a mentor. So it just makes permanency and a child living in a family, it makes a huge difference to mental health. And this year at our conference, we had a whole push on trauma care, which I'm really passionate about, because all these kids that are separated from their birth families suffer from trauma. And we have to attend to that and know that the sooner they're in a safe, loving home, the trauma will decrease. Children cannot thrive with having experienced trauma, and we need to get them into permanency as soon as possible.
So, Renee, if someone thinks that they're the sort of person who could open their home to a child in need, what should they do? What's the first step?
This year we've made it easy. If you go to ahomeforeverychild.org, you can find out information, register your interest, see what's involved. And really, like Deb said, kids need everyday things. So if you're someone that thinks that, you know, you've got a big enough house and you know, want to cook for the kids and make sure they know where they're sleeping that night, they're the things that need to be offered. So if you think you can do that, then you can come to the website and register your interest and find out more. And if not, as Deb said, you can support our work to find more homes.
Deb, what continues to drive your passion for this not-for-profit organisation that you founded? What keeps it top of your list of things that need to be done, need to be looked after?
There are 46,000 kids living in out-of-home care. That's outrageous. They need to know that they're important. So we are providing services. Like I always say to everyone, not everyone can become a carer. But if you're a tutor or a tap dance teacher or a chef, we have a mission that we supply for these kids where they can come in and we teach them life skills. They haven't had, you know, their parents to teach them how to cook, how to manage a home, how to do anything. Everyone can put their hand up to help. You know, you don't have to adopt a child. You can donate financially, or you can offer your services to show that they're cared for and they can learn skill sets.
Deb, you managed to come home to Australia a couple of times this year, and you were doing some work. You're in the sequel to The Dry with Eric Banner.
I don't know when it's coming out, but it was great. It was great to be home in Australia because I hadn't been back since COVID, and to film in Warburton in Victoria. Everyone's going to go and see Force of Nature, which will be hopefully as good as The Dry, even better.
River City isn't in any trouble.
Then I'll have to create some.
You got trouble.
Oh, we got trouble.
Right in River City.
Right in River City.
So when do we see you next? I know Hugh's just extended the run of The Music Man due to popular demand. So does that mean you guys won't get back for a bit?
He's still tap dancing. So when he stops tap dancing, we might be able to come on home and say hi. Yeah, exactly.
That's what keeps him there for the time being. Are you still loving New York?
I've been here for so long now. I'm such a New Yorker, but I mean, you know, I'm always an Aussie. I'm an Aussie in New York. But yeah, I love New York. I love this city. It's amazing.
Well, thank you for coming on today and talking about this crucial need. As we said, Renee, 4,000 homes, it doesn't sound that many, but each one is so crucially important.
Absolutely. And I think the reason it's so critical now is that when these children aren't in a home, and that's when we're talking about the 4,000, they're in group settings with workers on shift. It is not the same as being raised in a family. And when you can't find a home for a child as young as one, we know we have a national problem that we really just, if we think that if people knew about this need, they would be stepping up. And I think that's what we'll see in the coming weeks.
And Deb, if we could see, you know, some of those kids in a safe home environment in time for Christmas, that would just be everyone's Christmas wish come true.
That'd be a dream. So, you know, and we know it's a big ask. So people have to be aware of what is involved. And we have all the services that we can provide to support the families that are going to take care of these kids. So people should know that they'll get a lot of support if you take on a child. And again, it's not just, it's financial donations and it's also services. Please bring us all your skill sets and help us support these children.
Deb, Renee, thank you both so much for chatting to me today, and let's get the message out there. Let's get this happening.
Thanks so much.
Thanks.